Hello everybody, it's Ryno and I am here at Disney's Animal Kingdom and I'm hungry. Obviously you're on the Disney Dining Channel, so I'm probably always going to be eating whenever I show up on this channel. But like I said, I'm here at Animal Kingdom and I actually had a viewer, a listener, a fan of the content that we produce tell me that there was a plant-based option over here at Flame Tree Barbecue that was worth giving a try. I believe it is a sausage. I can't remember the full description. I'll double check when I get over there, but they mobile order here. So I'm gonna place my mobile order and then I'm gonna check it out. Cause you know me, I like to try plant-based options whenever I get the opportunity. So if it comes recommended, then hopefully I'm gonna enjoy it. So, and I still haven't found like a plant-based sausage hot dog thing that I'm in love with yet. So maybe today will be that day. But before I go in here, I just want to remind everybody that this and everything we do here at the Disney Dining Channel is brought to you by Dreams Unlimited Travel. They are experts at helping you plan the perfect Disney vacation. Visit them on the web at dreamsunlimitedtravel.com. When you book with them, it costs you nothing extra and you help support the show. I am dodging people left and right now. I am a magnet for human beings. It's a little crowded in this intersection area, so I'm getting hangry too. So I'm gonna go put my order in and we'll see what this is all about, what the hubbub's all about. But okay, so here is a look at the menu. So you got ribs and chicken, ooh, macaroni and cheese with pulled pork. Where is Steve Porter when you need him? Salad, chicken. And that's what we're getting. The Hot Link Smokehouse Sandwich, served with French fries. Not thrilled about it being with French fries, but $10.99. All right, we'll see how it goes. Check out my lime green background. I'm in love with it. What's crazy is like where Flame Tree Barbecue was, it was like kind of busy. Like if you just walk behind that building and down a little bit, there's a crazy amount of seating over here that I've never really noticed before. Maybe it was utilized for other stuff and it's just set up now because of all the COVID things, but I kind of came a little bit further down to the side of the building where the Mickey and Minnie, photos used to be. In here, and I think I'm actually near a cast member break room because a lot of cast members have kept walking by me. That, or they're just like me. I did find out a better description of the Hot Link sandwich here, and I messaged it to my watch, so excuse me while I look here. So this is the Hot Link Smokehouse Sandwich. I believe after tax it was maybe like $11.71 or $11.17. I can't see because it's on my phone, but this is a plant-based sausage topped with a tangy mustard barbecue sauce, slaw, and crispy onions on a house-made New England style roll. Hey, New England. You can see it here. It's got there. I feel like it's a little light on the sauce, but what is nice is they give you a wet nap here to use, a couple of them actually, and then she gave me a bunch of ketchup, and then she asked if I wanted extra barbecue sauce. So I've got extra. I'm gonna try it without that first, so let me take my mask off and I'm starving. I'm gonna go for some french fries first, even though french fries are french fries. Nice and cold. French fries really do not hold their heat very well, do they? Especially Disney ones. Yep. These are terrible. Let me dive into the sandwich. The Hot Link Smokehouse Sandwich. I walked like right up, right when they put this on the tray though, so this shouldn't be like cold, but it is kind of cold. I mean, I did take pictures and a little bit of video of it, but I haven't had it for long enough for it to be as chilled as it's feeling in my hand right now, but here we go. This is gonna be pretty for everybody out there. Okay. First impression, I think this plant-based sausage in here is fantastic. Do I wish it was a little bit warmer? Yes. I'm gonna take another bite. There's a little cross section for you before I get too far into this, but okay.
Yeah. The plant-based sausage in here is definitely the best I've ever had. That was 100% accurate. The mango, the slaw on top is great because I love the texture that it's giving it. It's adding a nice crunch to the dog. And I am obsessively looking for anything to crunch on during the day, all that sort of stuff. Like I just have that like macular issue where I always want to be crushing something with my teeth. For all the reasons you think. The slaw is good. It's honestly really light on the barbecue sauce. I'm not getting a lot of it. I do like the crispy, the onion strings in here because they are legit like crispy. And so you've got like that, you know, that crunch from the slaw, which has like the carrots and I think it's like cabbage. And then adding that like crispy, salty, extra little onion ring is actually really, really good. I'm gonna add just a little bit of the standard barbecue sauce, just because I'm curious, but I don't want to ruin it. Just a little bit on there. Ooh, pretty sweet barbecue sauce actually, but. The barbecue sauce is fine, it's really sweet, but I say don't add the barbecue sauce. Go with it the way it is. If you can get more of this tangy mustard barbecue sauce to add to it, I would 100% say add that, because that is just bringing up these flavors of this dog to that next level. The flavors of this one are definitely more reminiscent of like a bratwurst or a hot dog. So if that's what you're looking for, I'm not 100% how to describe that. Pork flavors, I guess. It's good. I love a good New England roll. The thing is, it can be very bready. So that's why I wish it just had a little bit more of this mango barbecue sauce on top. I feel like they were so light with that. But on the flip side, I feel like somebody's gonna get it and it's gonna be like drenched in it. So if there's a way that you could ask for it on the side, I'm definitely gonna say do that. But let me take a couple more bites. Let me finish inhaling this and then I'll give you the wrap up of what I think after I'm done. I feel like I should get a second one.
I'm done. I mean, you saw it in the video. I pretty much inhaled that thing. Consensus is definitely worth it. I really enjoyed it. I do think it's a shame right now with the mobile ordering that, because it's like the app, if you can't modify anything in there, then you're just like kind of stuck with what you have, because I definitely would have asked to not have the fries. I think it would have been like better with like apple slices or carrots on the side. That's just me though. Some people, you just need your fries and that's okay. Everybody loves fries. I just think it would have been paired great with something like sweet on the side to go with that like spice, that tangy, that mustard barbecue sauce, because whew, that was good. That was really good. The whole thing was good. It was A+ for like flavors, texture, all that sort of stuff. A nice option here to have, because normally when I'm looking for something like plant-based or anything like that, I go toward Satouli Canteen. So I know there's a plant-based burger at Restaurantosaurus. I think maybe Craig might have tried it. I'm not sure. If he didn't, I'm coming back and I'm trying it. But always good to have those sort of options. I really enjoy it. So, I gotta give it a good, I'm gonna give it a good review. And I believe that, if you're wondering about the actual barbecue from Flame Tree Barbecue, Craig, not too long ago, did a review of that here. And I believe he also spoke highly of it, but you'll find that video on this channel as well. So if you did enjoy this, this video, please give it a thumbs up, consider following the channel. And obviously leave some comments. I would love feedback where you've had some great plant-based options, vegetarian options, vegan options. It doesn't even have to be any of that. I like cool food. So just tell me where the coolest food item is that you've had, the most unique food items that you've had at Walt Disney World, and I would love to go give them a try. So thank you everybody for dealing with me and watching me stumble through this. Remember, the next time you are booking a Disney vacation, please consider booking with Dreams Unlimited Travel. And that is gonna do it for me. I will see you next time. Goodbye, everybody.